Now more Commitment 2010 coverage as we try to navigate our way through the race in the 17th Congressional District.
Incumbent Democrat Tim Holden is being challenged by State Senator Dave Argall. Well, News 8's Anne Shannon took the candidates on a district-wide road trip to talk about these issues. Anne.
Well, hey guys, tonight we are on the road with Dave Argall. We've already stopped in Harrisburg to talk about health care reform and Social Security. Our next stop took us to Lebanon, where the Chesapeake Bay cleanup, renewable energy, and again, health care reform were hot topics. Next up.
It's mid-afternoon on a sunny day in the 17th Congressional District. We've covered highways and byways with candidate Dave Argall. So far, we've visited a senior home and a farm to talk about the issues facing voters in this area. As we head to our next destination, our conversation turns to the campaign ads that have been targeting Argall.
There has been some criticism about the fact that you have an apartment in Harrisburg, have taken per diems, meal money, that kind of thing. How do you defend that?
I think it's kind of interesting that the congressman who makes twice as much as a state legislator does complains about the fact that we get an allowance.
Argall, who lives 80 miles from the Capitol, is allowed to keep an apartment and take state money for expenses. He says while it's not an ideal system, he will take advantage of it.
We've also been hit hard by the Holden campaign for voting yes on the pay raise.
Yes. Very interesting. He didn't complain about it in 2005 when it happened. He didn't complain about it when it 2006, 2007, 2008, 2009. He's trying to wrap it around my neck.
Argall admits the pay raise vote was a mistake, one he won't make again, even if elected to Congress. Our conversation wraps up as we make our way into Pottsville.
All right, we're at our next stop.
We've arrived at the Lipkin Building, a technology incubator here.
Hi. Good, how are you doing?
Dave Kunsek is the owner of Page One Website Design. He works primarily with small to medium-sized businesses.
Ran it off my kitchen table for the first 2 years. You know, it just came to a point where clients were wanting to meet me at the office, but it wasn't working no more.
So Dave moves his business here and now employs three people. He's also the father of young children. He's concerned about taxes for the middle class if the tax breaks that were established under the Bush administration aren't renewed by the current Congress.
Mine's going to go up 10% along with my employees and obviously other small business owners. I was kind of curious where you stood on that.
We've got to get those tax cuts in because, I mean, this is the worst possible time
in the midst of
this economy to even think about raising taxes.
But, you know, there's companies in the area here that are, you know, they're sitting on capital because they're afraid to make the move because there's not enough consumer confidence to move the products.
I think we need to control the spending. I think we need to look for some reasonable, rational spending cuts.
Again, you touched on it right too, unemployment. You know, like right now we're at 11, and just I was looking back, you know, the worst that's ever been around here was 12.9.
I think you really need to have government control the spending and control the taxes. I think that's the first step. Of course, the only way we can do that, we have to fire Nancy Pelosi.
We wrap things up with a tour of Page One's offices. Then it's back to the van.
Another good stop. This one, technology. He had some interesting concerns.
I ask Argall his position on the tax cuts.
I want to continue the tax cuts that were put in place 8, 9, 10 years ago, and I want to do it for everyone, employees and employers.
As we head out of Pottsville, Argall is quick to lay blame for the district's problems on his opponent, Tim Holden, and the current Congress. He says there's been too much spending and the stimulus just isn't working. Meanwhile, Argall is feeling optimistic. In just the time we've been together, he's gotten some important campaign news.
I'm thrilled to hear that we've gotten the endorsement of the United States at Chamber of Commerce. That is a huge, plus for the campaign. But also, we got one from one of the smaller groups. There's a FOP lodge here in Schuylkill County. Tim Holden's actually a member. He was a former sheriff. They're endorsing me.
Dave Argall tells me he is feeling very confident as we head into these final days of the race. And, of course, coming up tomorrow night on News 8, we're going to hit the road with Tim Holden.
Of course.
Perfect. Now, will there be a debate between these two?
There was a scheduled debate, but that has been canceled because Congressman Holden's mother is very ill. So they've both agreed to forego the debate.
All right. Thank you, Anne.
Thank you, Anne.